And welcome to this new video. In this video we will be checking out the Zoom H4n Pro, which is the successor to the H4n. Yeah, usually I record with the old Zoom H4n, which I own since I think 1.5 years, but now it broke on its own and I wanted to return it. Thankfully the store returned it for a Zoom H5, which is the next bigger model, but this was the most unreliable and worst recorder I have ever seen in my entire life. So I went to the store again and they exchanged it for the Zoom H4n Pro, which is yeah totally familiar with me and I can yeah use just fine, unlike the Zoom H5, which really was a very bad recorder for me. Yeah, now let's get into the batteries first, as I bought these ones and not these alkaline batteries, but these are nickel metal whatever batteries, so they are rechargeable. Usually I would be fine with these alkaline batteries, but with the Phantom Power they always get, I don't know, empty after I think 2 recordings. So it's a total waste of batteries and also not that great for the nature. So I thought I could invest some money in some rechargeable batteries. Let's put this aside. Yeah, I think these are quite good ones by Panasonic or Panasonic, I don't know. We have 4 ones in here which are rechargeable in 1.5 hours. I think they should last for around 2 or 3 hours and the recorder would just, yeah, just fine. But now let's put these aside and focus on the recorder here. Oh, there's some tape at the top. I have no knife here, so maybe we can pull it off. And like I said, I'm totally familiar with the H4n Pro or with the H4n, just because I yeah, use it often or all the time. And the H5 really had some problems. I think it only was my unit, as it wasn't reliable. Sometimes it simply turned off. Sometimes it wouldn't recognize my SD card, which just is yeah, a total rip-off for over $300. But now we got the H4n Pro here. And let's take it out here. And just like all the others, it comes in this nice carrying case. Let's take it out. Just like the AA batteries. And yeah, just like always with Zoom products, you get a lot of manuals, which already are like half the size and weight of the entire package. But I think this is everything we get. Not that many accessories like with the Zoom H5. You got yeah a pop guard, I think, and yeah many other things like a, I don't know, mini USB cable and more stuff. But I think this should be enough for me. I think it is in frame. Let's zoom out a bit. This was a bit too close. And of course, you can already hear that I'm recording this through the microphone of my camera, which of course sounds very bad. But yeah, let's take it out now. And I really think this is an enjoyable and very nice looking product. We also have the old H4n here. It was in a similar carrying case or even the exact same one. And yeah, I even like the design of the older one more. It looks a bit more symmetrical. I really love the design, as also the buttons felt very nice. The record button sounded like this. And with the new Zoom products, you can't really press it, you don't really get a tactile feedback, which I think isn't that great, but I can live with it. And the H4n Pro also has some internal improvements. So it has the exact same preamps as the way bigger H6 and H5, which of course should deliver even better results than from the old H4n. Like I already told you, my old Zoom H4n is totally broken, it doesn't do anything anymore. If you turn it on, it only says Zoom and nothing else. You can wait for 2 hours, you can connect it to the laptop. Yeah, nothing will happen, so this thing really yeah, is broken or something. Maybe a part is loose inside, but I don't know. I'm not really into fixing mics. But now, let's put in the battery to the Zoom H4n Pro. Let's cut these open first. And here we go, we can unwrap them and put the batteries inside of here. Yeah, I think design and features are equal to the H4n, which is of course the predecessor to the H4n Pro. I think it has an improved speaker, of course improved internals with the new preamps, and I think it can also handle big mics a bit better due to the stronger preamps inside. But now let's turn it on for the first time. And of course, the next new thing is the new backlight. So it lights up blue instead of this, yeah, strange looking orange. Of course, I forgot to insert my SD card. And let's wait for some seconds for the SD card to be, I don't know, recognized. And then I'll be back in a minute, as this always takes some time with the Zoom products. With the H5, I think it took me about 5 minutes, which was way too long. And when you hit the pause button or the stop button with the H5, I think it took the H5 around maybe 1 minute to save a recording, which is about 10 seconds long, which of course was awful. But now let's simply wait for the H4n Pro to recognize the SD card, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, so now we are set up and ready to go. I opened up a new folder, and I also set up everything for my binaural microphones, which are phantom powered by this new XLR port here. I call it new because it has these new push things, so the XLR ports don't, I don't know, get pulled off as easily as on the old one. So here you didn't have this, and if someone just pulled on them, they could easily come off. And with the new one, you have to first press this push button here, and then you can pull them off. Yeah, so now I set up everything. Also, the recording quality is a bit higher this time, so you will get even better results than from the other videos with the old recorder. But now let's take out my binaural microphones from my packaging here and instantly try them out. So now you are hearing me talking through my new setup. What I also just noticed is that the loading times of the Zoom H4n are way quicker than on the other models, like the Zoom H4n without the Pro and the Zoom H5. Yeah, and also the gain is quite a bit different, so it doesn't peak as fast as the older models. So if I would have done this peak with the H4n, it would have peaked here. And it would blink as crazy, but now with the H4n Pro, it somehow, yeah, I don't know, is more stable. So if I say peak, you won't hear this pop noise. So yeah, this is really a great product. I'm super satisfied with it. The H5 really was a mess to set up, it was a mess to use, and now I only have to switch to my yeah, nickel metal whatever batteries. And then, yeah, I have my new setup ready to go. Of course, I wouldn't have bought this one, or I wouldn't have returned the old one, when it wasn't broken. So yeah, somehow, like I already explained you, this won't work anymore, doesn't turn on, or yeah, doesn't work. So I had to return it for this one. I just went to the store and told them, yeah, look, it is broken. And they didn't even want to have the older model, as they couldn't do anything, it was totally broken. So they gave me this one, said, yeah, get lucky with it. Yeah, so I think this is it. I'm very satisfied with the Zoom H4n Pro. It also is, I think, the newest model from their lineup, so it should be the most modern, best working one, and so far it looks like it is indeed the best one. So yeah, of course, I hope you enjoyed this and you stay tuned for more speaker comparisons following up soon. I really have made a big break here, as I had to do a lot of stuff for the school. We had a lot of tests and exams, but now they are all over and I have all of my equipment together, and now I can record many more videos. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Until then, have a great time and bye bye.